First game, guys. Fire to go. ACCM cool. There you go. Alright. I did back. This would be the best. This would be better than the previous one as well. Well, let's go. LG and overlay settings. Overlay settings. Look, where is the overlay? Move the table. Let's put here. Yeah, I have to remove the fishing ship. I don't need the fishing ships on Arabia. Trade card, kill dead, castles and relics. All that is good. All right. Yeah, we have everything there. And we have Goths, Franks. Whoa, this matchup is awesome. Goths, Franks, Celts, Mayans. We will take 1-for-1 fire with blue. And he has Franks. Frank civilization. Okay, let's check Frank civilization. Okay. Frank civilization mainly is strong after Castle Age. So it's really, really recommended that he's going for the dress and go Castle Age, because the knights are going to be really, 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 really strong. I'm telling you. Well, then we go to other point of view. Cool Green in the north, who is facing Dogal. He has right Mayan civilization and he's facing the gods. Choose the opposite. Mayans, come to me, Mayans, come to me, Mayans. They are archer civilization. A looking imperial, how cheap they will be. Also, the resources last longer, so great civilization. Really, really great civilization, but against gods, it's a matchup that I want to see, really. Then red, Dogal with the gods, which is amazing. Thank you for the subscription. Look how beautiful this looking.
I remember when this channel was just YouTube videos. Feels bad, man.
Dogal with the gods, right? God civilization, infantry is perfect, absolutely perfect counter with the Mayans. Look how cheap it is. I will go for militias after Feudal Age, but anyway, this is super strong in late game. Dogal red on the left, and the last one, purple, ACCM, Kells. Hello everyone that is joining, I'm focusing now in the professional mode, sorry if I don't say hello to everyone. Kells, and Kells facing the Franks. Well, Kells is super strong, in my opinion. Better matchup from Kells here. It depends how they play. Infantry move faster. Lumberjacks work 15% faster. Siege weapon fires 20% faster as well. Well, it's just great civilization. And let's see. Stronger in early game. Thank you for the following, guys. Thank you everyone for joining the channel. Well, right now, and now with all visible, we are going to see how purple ACCM is going closer and closer to fire. Let's see if he's gonna lane. Let's see if we're going to see some lane. We can see also how Dogal was trying to... No, but he took already both boars. That's the way to go. Take the boars as soon as possible, so you avoid any laming. Hopefully the sound now is good. Music, sound in game, my boys, tell me if all the levels are good, because really, with the tournaments, I want to do my best. Three villages on wood. Three villages only on wood, so Dogal is going as scouts? This is interesting. In the other side, we have Franks. Five with four villages. Might be for the Drash. It's green like Arabia. Yes, Taria, I know. The other one was for the Whisper mode, and I forgot to activate it. And, well, purple ACCN gonna make the Baroque already on top of that hill. Expected with Kells is the way to go. Is really the way to go. He need to take gold. Probably he's gonna make the barrack, and after the barrack he might take the gold. Yeah, I think so. So you can see this build order. He's doing in 19 population. You see 20 the barrack. Then he's gonna mine 10 gold because he need exactly 110 gold to be able to make three militias and the loom. All right. Now green. Well, oh, I didn't notice. Cool, lame the boar. What the hell? What the hell? He lame the boar? Are you for real? And I didn't notice. Let's go to cool point of view. He can see the third boar at the back. All right, so he is with one boar more. Remember, guys, in this tournament, something that I think it's really, really great, no restarts.
Thank you for
restart.
Following.
Thank you for the following. Following hype, man. Following train, which is amazing. Welcome to the channel, everyone. 13 moves, man. 13 moves, man. Over a year. That's just amazing, man. Just amazing. Thank you for the resubscription, guys. Really, really appreciate it. It's awesome. It's really, really awesome, the support. Fantastic. Cool. With 26 population, Barak, and now taking the berries, okay, 3 boards, oh, he's building like this, interesting, really, really interesting, delete some wood, so many actually, for one lumber can. Well, now he will start to add as much as possible farms, okay, 24 population, 24, 23, it's pretty similar, green cool with 28, Now going with demolitions, Dogao is up, 24 population, of course, he couldn't go faster, he has only one boar, his palisade, one lumber camp only, and, oh, let's see what he's planning, stone, he's mining stone, so he's gonna go defensive, really defensive actually, wow, oh, well, that's a good mining camp, fast reaction for Dogao, yeah, he's gonna play super defensive, damn. I don't know if this is going to be good, it's only 2 villages, but let's see what he's planning to do. I don't know what he's planning, maybe he just planned to go towers and try to go castle edge. It's possible, it's really, really possible, because Dogao don't even have a barrack, don't even have a Obama, or he's going to sling fire, maybe? Nah, I don't think so, well, anything can happen. This is open here. He can, well, he don't know if there is one tree, one hole, or it's close, but I'll put the village now. What is Dogao trying to do, really? Fire is going archery range, okay, archery range with 3 farmers, interesting, and, oh, he was trying to push the deer, and now he's gonna lose the scout. Well, this is weird. Look at his resources. He's trying to go for a fast castle or what? I don't know. What is Dogao doing, guys? Can you tell me? I'm not an expert. Fast castle. And his link? Oh, fast castle. Yeah, fast castle with the castle and huge cult. Whoa! Okay, but his resources are not the best. Now 3 villages on goal. Ay, ay, ay. Well, it seems he knows that green is probably going to go feudal trash and go castle age. That's the way to go. He's losing the militias. Now cool can see. Well, use the blast, man. Okay. Now we'll go castle age as well. Nice. Okay. Wildfire in problems. The Manatarms are there. Manatarm from Kells. ACCM. He has 2 archery ranges. I think a tower here would be ideal. We'll cover the gold. We'll cover the stone. He will palisade till the edge of the map. And he will have all that part covered. He's doing the blacksmith. Yeah, because he is still wide open. But now, archers and skirmishers. Is he going to be able to kill a villager at least? 4 men at times is a lot, killing 1 villager. There you go. Go to kill the skirmishers. You want to kill the skirms better. Yes, that's the way to go. I still on the Dogao point of view. Why? Because he is really at the limit with the economy. But he's gonna make 2 houses. He don't want to make a tower there. Well, maybe he should. Ah, he's doing. All right. All right. Yeah, it's the way to go. 2 archery ranges. Cool is going 10 aggressive. Nah, he's on the way to Castle Edge already. On the way to Castle Edge already. Ay, ay, ay. This is looking good, man. This is looking good. But Dogao. Nah, Dogao is still far. Still far. Well, after the wheelbarrow, he will go up. But by the time he is in Castle Edge, I assume for that he's doing towers. All right. I don't know if maybe it would be better to make the tower on top of that hill. It's not Titanic, but absolutely the advantage. It's on Vietnam right now. Well, Vietnam is they are top players, man. They are really top players. Probably we are like not more fun, but more known the other players. More than the Asians, but come on, man, everyone know ACCM and cool, right? Everyone, from Nations Cap and so on, he's doing the tower, he's now walling exactly the way I said, one tower, walling till the edge of the map, so front, it's completely fine, 18 minutes 24 seconds is like almost 2 minutes delayed in Castle Age, but with a tower there and getting stoned to make a castle, the power of the Huskals can make the difference. But Cool could try to go aggressive, could try to kill a lot of villages, and or he could go to fire double and destroy blue. But a push with the Huskals can be so dangerous. Anyway, Dogao economy is pretty weak, so even if he has some archers there with the fletching, he's gonna lose those archers, you see. Well, he lost some. No, he didn't, because he went back in time. And now, just go to the other guy. Exactly, double him. Double and kill it. Well, let's see, it's really important. Cool with the crossbows. Is he sending? Well, he's exploring. He can see that all the wood is wall. But imagine if he's doing a tower here. And don't let Dogao mine a stone. You see, both stone forward has the tower here. He did a mini base, but a tower here would be great. Or siege instantly, right? Well, let's see. Let's see. Oh, he's doing what? A town center. Well, he's just going for the standard, booming, and trying to get a better economy. Now purple is going back. Okay, he has the crossbows, Bodkin arrow. Well, even with Bodkin, he can delay himself. Dogao to mine a stone. Yeah, man. Population Dogao 29 only. 29 only. While the others 42, 46, and his guy is in Castle Age for some time ago, actually. Alright. Go. Oh, a lot of people joining the channel. Thank you for joining, guys. You will enjoy, hopefully, at least. Hello, everyone. More crossbows coming. He's gonna kill now those villagers. Ay, he's killing the villagers. No, he's not doing the damage yet. He's trying to go. He needs a bit more. Hello, the Viper fan. How you doing, man? Welcome everyone to the channel. 48, 47, 53, 31, really low, but the population, I mean, here, he want to go boom, with the same almost villages, no army, but he's killing now more. Oh, he didn't see it, and he can go from behind, go to the TC, ah, he didn't see it, man. Imagine if he's got, oh, he saw it now, it's only two archers, ay. Let's go to Dogao. He's doing another thing. The castle is happening. Let's go to Cool point of view. He's killing the villagers. This is game, man. If he's not letting him make the castle, that's it, man. That's it. The range from the tower is how much? 8. And 7, the archers. For that, he's gonna be more or less okay. Ay. He's losing now some archers. Dogao population 32. 32 population. I know that you might think, oh, this is titanic, and it is, but yeah, he's not letting him make the castle. If he's not doing the castle, that's it, man. Yeah, but he has the tower to protect, and really with 3-4 Huskals he can do a lot of damage on Cool. Absolutely a lot of damage. Sorry guys, my wife needed me, and I have to go super fast. I had to help my wife with something. Anyway, he couldn't open the door. She was coming along with my two kids, and I had to open the door to her. Okay, well, ACCM, 46 population, he's walling now, ACCM, oh man, but he's gonna be in Castle Age. Just make a siege workshop, don't be stubborn. Well, he's trying to wall, he's trying fire to go aggressive, but now, siege workshop, oh man, okay. Well, I have to do what I have to do, right? Well, he's doing a tower now, whoa, aggressive play. I was focused completely in this side. You can see how Dogao has 44 Valiant Cool 52, but ACC M36. Fire 41, but he's in Castle 8. He's doing another tower here. He's mining a stone. He needs siege, man. But ACCM doesn't have any resources. And no knights, crossbows. He doesn't have the market, so till he's getting the wood, he's in some problems. He's in really, really, really some problems. Oh, but he has crossbows, is still killing.
Thank you for following.
In Fire Home. Whoa, the game is really, really nice. You can see there is a lot of action. Now he did a house. Okay, the huge cult might do the difference here. Yeah, Dogal might be okay. I think he might be okay. But those crossbows, whoa, and he's sending huge cult to help. Whoa, man. Oh, man. You will see how much damage they can do. You see all the flaring when I am on Brazilian's point of view pliers? Well, five arches, those huge cults might kill the arches, definitely. Well, depend if he's microing properly. Now, siege workshop. Don't let him make another tower here or we'll be out of wood. Is towers with plus two? Alright. And fire? Well, fire is still far from going up Castle Edge. Far from going up Castle Edge. He can go now with the crossbows, but I can imagine that cool economy might be really good. And he's doing what?
Thank you for following.
Oh, barracks and men at arms, man. Barracks and men at arms. Wow. Welcome to the channel, guys. Welcome to the channel. Of course that you can chat. All right. Oh, look at the crossbows. Look at those skirmishers. One, two. Archery ranges. Long swordsman. Okay. He did a market fire there. Nice. Well, with the siege. Go, go, man. I want to see the blood, man. Let's see if ACCM. I put the point of view. Fog of war. Oh, man. Well, fire is still in problems. He's still in feudal age while all the other are in castle age. Look at those huge skulls. But now he's coming with monks, long swordsmen, and with those arches. And converting with the monk, he might be in a really good position. Let's see. He's converting or not? He's killing, man. But he's not converting. Convert, man. Yeah, well, it was sloppy, but he got one huge skull. And now with that, yeah, he's fine, man. He's really fine. He's gonna kill all that. Now fire is on the way to Castle Edge. He's killing that tower. He killed the other one. Now he's gonna make a TC there. We'll just put the lumberjack in that spot. And that's it. He can make... He's doing another mangonel. He's really in okay position. Population is pretty much the same. And if they send you few archers, fire will be in a terrible, in a disaster position. While in the other side, cool, doing the ballistic, doing all the damn upgrades, but Dogal, it's now booming strong, I guess. Alright, 80 population, but cool, guys, 100, man. 100 population. 100 population. He's sending the knights. Yeah, he has knights as well. So all those skirmishers can go to the hell really fast. It's just skirmishers, so he can kill easily. And here he's trying to wall. Yeah, not in time. Not in time. Bye bye the Valier. Well, he's gonna kill. He's gonna kill the Valier. There you go. Fire. A bit of Titanic. Well, he's gonna kill the tower. He's gonna. Oh, he's trying, but he can't. Nah, he's losing one Valier at least. Go and kill the Mangonel. Oh, he's trapping for what? I don't know what he's trying to do here. Well, he's losing all the villagers. Yeah, definitely. Go back, man. Don't lose that knight for nothing anyway. Not really, really important. He has now more knights incoming. He's gonna lose a villager. He's gonna be in castle, but he's 56 population. Actually, ACCM is only 63, so he's not really ahead. But cool. Cool. It's on the way to Imperial, guys. On the way to Imperial. But the thing is, is he going to be able to stop the Huskal power with the Anarchy, even if he's going to be an Imperial? Is he going to go long swordsman all the time? Is he going to switch to Eagles? What he's going to do? This is gonna be really, really interesting. The Mayans versus the Gods. With Mayans huge advantage. Well, huge. He's gonna be an Imperial, right? But look at this army, plus one. Now go back. Ay, ay, ay. You see how important it is that you know completely the civilizations? And of course, at this level, they know everything. Absolutely everything. Well, here he's defending now properly. He has 2000. He's gonna kill that Valier. Bam, bam. Down the Valier. Go and kill the... kill the tower, not the market, man. The tower, I think ACCM didn't notice. And here, this is the push from Kool. Well, he's trying at least. I think Kool should make a castle that he has the stone. He doesn't. And now, Blue is coming with knights and skirmishers, man. But he's still... look at this, man. Oh my god, he's going to lose the... he's going to lose the Mangoral, man. He didn't kill the tower. 43 HP. He forgot, and now... oh, he got it in the last second. He remembered, and now open. Going to lose the Mangonel. Come on. Well, fire plus two knights. Now he's pushing with plus two knights. He has. He's gonna make a monastery, but ACCM, man, don't titanic, man, don't titanic. Panic mode activated. Billy's on the TC. Billy's on the TC. He's gonna win. He won it, man, 44 HP, and now he can... whoa, that was a nice building, beautiful. Well, in the other side, like I told you, the power of the Huskal versus those long swords, man. Ay, 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 200 swords, but the Huskals are stronger for now, I think. Is he converting or not? No, losing. Now, but he has a lot of farming. Look at Kryn, man, the Kryn is playing awesome. Population is exactly the same. The problem is... is Dogao going to be able to go up Imperial ever? And now he will have 200 swords. If he's been all the average, plus 2, plus 2, and then plus 4, plus 4, they are going to be an oath to kill the gods. In Castellage, yes. He's doing another castle to protect the TCs. I think he will make it here. Why? Because he can still raid a lot here. I mean, if you make the some upgrades. Anyway, population is almost the same for everyone. For everyone. Why? Because... fire is pushing properly, but ACCM 68 fire 46. He has a terrible economy. Now he's doing an extra tone center and he's trying to push that reason. Plus 2, plus 1, just go away a bit. He just need to go ramps or a castle, man. Yeah, he's doing the castle, that's it. Trebuchet and just wait. You kill the castles and that's it. Oh! Dogao, man! Dogao! Dogao is on the way to Imperial. The music in the background is just good with the game. Medieval Total War music is amazing. And it's coming in the right moment. It seems that the music is interacting with the game, right? It's amazing. Amazing. I love it. But Dogao, even under the pressure, is on the way to Imperial. The power of the gods. I want to see this. The Mayas is going to be able to kill the gods. Oh, man. Well, population pretty similar. Dogao, 108 villagers. Kool, 99 villagers. And now, you can see his base. Beautiful. Crazy boom. Crazy, crazy boom. Halfway to Imperial Dogao. We are waiting. We are waiting for the Imperial Age. But Kool, it will be in time to make Trebuchetes. Come on, man. Come on. He need to do it fast as possible before Dogao get all the damn upgrades. Otherwise, big problems. Yes, go away, just wait the castle, the threat better said. While in the other side, gonna make another TC. He's sending 4 knights plus 2, but he has another town center as well. Yeah, ACCM has a good booming coming. And now, Neil University, more barracks. Let's see ACCM resources. Alright, well, he's at the limit, no gold. Put some villagers, trying to kill the knights. Still not taking any gold. What the hell is he doing? Why no gold? And now, here, this spot, this is the more important in the game, because in the other side, they are not going to be able to kill each other yet. And another castle forward, killing the town center. Well, Dogao might have the Imperial TC used in the middle, all right. Well protected, now one Trebuchet, one TC down. Gonna make another. Kool is doing the Arbalest. He has plus 2, plus 4, 200 swords. Oh man, he's gonna have the same army really, really soon. But Dogao, that he has the perfusion, he's doing 2 Trebuchet. Long swordsman, 200 swordsman, sorry. Plus 2, plus 2, Blast Furnace. Man, well, he's at the limit, that's the problem. Perfusion need also, I don't remember how much wood, but it need like 400 wood, I think. It need good amount of wood to make those upgrades. He's at the very limit, but if he's able to pump Champions, for example, wow! Champions have few huge skulls. The fight is there, +2/+2, but +2/+4 for cool, right? And with the Arbalest support, the Arbalest against the standard infantry are good. Against the huge skull is another thing, but be careful, cool. Be careful, there's two castles. You are taking a fight under the two castles. Now, Plume Archers, Arbalest, they can do some good job, but the power of the gods. It's really risky. He's gonna try to raid. Ay, 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 you don't want at home. The raiding can be real. And they are trying to raid. Oh my god. Let's see, man. Let's see. Well, ACCM should have a really huge advantage with fire. Is he gonna take it? It's 16 abilities, 17 now. With the long swords, is he gonna kill the traps? He need to protect it. Is he repairing the trap? No! He lost one trebuchet. Now with those two trebuchets, he is trying to kill the castle. He need to cover. He need to defend the champion. He's already there. Champions. And few huge skull. Is he raiding? Yes, he's still raiding. Now, the multitasking become crucial. Well, he did another TC, so he was well protected. He's still mining a lot of gold. So even if he's losing some, he's fine. The important fight here, is he gonna be able, the Mayans, to keep Dogao away from this fight? Dogao is doing an excellent job, really, and fire that was really, really behind. Oh, don't let ACCM to finish him. ACCM, are you going to go up? Yes, his resources are getting better and better, and the power of Celts who paid off. Well, he's trying to convert the pikes. It's no problem. You can spam pikes. They are super, super cheap. And also, some wood raiders will be good. They are super fast as well. Now the pikes are doing the job. He's killing all the knights. Now fire is in big problems. Or he's gonna be in big problems because the Celts, ACCM, it's on the way to Imperial. Skin mail armor, all the average on the way hand card. Dogao is at the limit, he is defending, the population is really close, he's trying to raid and he's raiding, but now he's countering with those local hunter swordsmen. But I insist, he need one good attack with those gods, with those Huskals, sorry, it's not elite Huskals, in my ACCM horse collar, Idolfix is always in our heart, but he's also always in the expert. Wow, Idolfix gonna get fabulous with his upgrades. Huge cost, he's gonna kill all those Arbalest, right? Yes, Arbalest, Blue Marches, he's now killing a lot. Those huge cost, ay, 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 ay. You don't wanna lose that army. But still, two castles, he's still doing a good job. But the huge cost kill a lot. And he's killing the trap, whoa! This is the most important, killing the traps. And look at the gods, man, I'm telling you guys, the Gal gonna kill everything. The power of the gods. You probably need the eagles or I don't know. And the Celts need to go there with the wood raiders. This is gonna be sick. Gonna be sick. The trebuchets are down, and now he's completely down that army. Cool, still 39 popular army. Dogao only 26. But even like this, he's getting absolutely everything. Yes, they can. He can fight under the castle. Definitely eagles or more long swordsmen he need. But now he's a complicated position. He will need the Celts. He will need the wood raiders going there. But come on, man, don't drop. Just a little pause, but don't drop, please. The game is keep going. All right. Fire on the way to Imperial, man. On the way to Imperial. But you can see ACCM with a forward castle sending the wood raiders. Go, go, go and kill the Mangonel. Ooh. Well, that just awake the beast. Well, the Huskals are doing the job, like I'm telling you, he's gonna push him back here. Let's see what timing he can do to stop the gods. Now, Dogao and fire, the scores start to switch. Dogao leading the score in the game with the population, with everything, with absolutely everything. Whoa, he's completely well there, he can take even more stone. The Celts destroy the Franks and the Celts destroy the gods, but we'll have ACCM good resources to do the difference. Yeah, absolutely. I think Celts can do it, man. Let's see, man. Let's see. The score is switching, which is unbelievable. ACCM seems to have a good advantage with fire. Billy is the same, 102. But ACCM, 30 army, fire, 4. 4, or basically nothing, right? Well, Castle covering the goal. Another siege wars of 1-2. Castle, two archery ranges, the barrack. Those Huskers are beast, but the Wood Raiders are also beast, guys. He has lost two castles. Now he needs to gather army at the back. Pienescu is doing the chemistry. He's sending more and more longhand swordsmen. That he has more castles. He has one castle at home, right? Where it is at home, exactly. He should wall and he did it. But he's coming with the Huskers. Alright. Elite Wood Raiders. It's Elite Wood Raiders happening. Elite Wood Raiders plus 4. Elite Wood Raiders plus 4. Let's see, because the Kells is the key in this game. Is the key in this game. How he's gonna use them. The gods, really easy to raid. And let's see if they are going to raid, actually. Well, look at the market. Cartography now, minute 48 cartography. I think he's really needed faster, man. Okay, he's doing the cartography now. Fire has the cartography. Cool doesn't have the cartography either. What the hell, and the law has. So you can see, basically, Cool and ACCM is zero teamwork. They were just playing 1v1 in both sides, right? Now maybe they are going to help a bit, but with a lot of long swordsmen, plus 2, plus 4, now doing the plus 4 as well, he can do some damage, but he will need champions. The problem is that the Kells can do the job here. We will see fire is still really low population. Oh, I was telling that they destroy Elite Axeman. If he's doing a lot of Elite Axeman, that's the way to go as well. But he doesn't have the numbers, or so it seems. Don't go. Where are you going? To kill the police. Yes, he's doing the job. You can see 148, but fire is trying to defend. That's the castle. That castle is probably going to go down. The other castle is really, really at the back. So he's gonna push this. That TC is going to be gone. Definitely. The score is gonna switch probably really soon. Oh man, but he's ready, man. But if he's ready, is he gonna be able to push? The problem is, Mayan seems to be really useless in this matchup. You notice? He's unable to push. Unable to push. Probably the Mayan should switch to blue, to fire, and purple should go to the gods, really. Anyway, the raiding is real. The raiding is real. Dogao, Dogao getting closer and closer to the pub limit. And now, how many villages he's killing? Well, good amount, man. Castle down. TC going to be down. Go and kill those villagers. Don't kill the fucking mining camp. Frank is more useless than Mayans. Well, it depends, man. It depends, because if you put together the power of the gods with halves and champion Huskers and Frank with hand cannoneers and paladins, you know, but for that you need a good economy, a good trade. You have to get the initiative in the game. Franks need a huge economy as well to do that army, but that's not the case. Why is not the case? Because they are under the big pressure. The game has been all the time push, right? So fire is not with the great economy. We can go to fire point of view. You can see that he's at the limit. He has 130 population, yes, but almost no army at all. Trebuchet, Axeman, he's gonna get pushed. Yeah, all the military buildings, he's just defending the Trebuchet, and that's it. Well, in the other side, well, there's a lot of gold. Yeah, well, fire is going there to make a town center. Yeah, okay, let's see. But he's there now with the blue marches. He's sending a lot of slow swordsmen and blue marchers. Oh man. Okay, let's see. Finally, they're doing a good teamwork. Champions going to the other side. A lot of Huskers. Red, Dogao is still in a strong, crazy strong position. Look at his score. Unbelievable game. Unbelievable game that the game keep going and fire 142 population. Look at ACCM population. He has lost a lot of villages. A lot of villages. 83 villages and 20 are idle. But I guess that cool resources are huge. So he might be able to sling a bit to his teammates. He should do it, in my opinion. ACCM, 0 wood, 0 food, 2000 gold. Great balance economy, but that happens a lot because he lost, he was raided, and he is still with some Huskar. Yeah, doing the damage. Almost no farmers. Yeah, 38 fighters is fine. With a lot of fighters. Blue March is now raiding. What is this, man? Now Cool and NCCM are leading again. The game is absolutely fantastic. Super crazy. Action all over the map. I don't even know where to fucking focus. But now he's coming with Trebuchet. And the Wind Raiders are doing definitely the great job. And with Blue March's support, that's it, man. That's it. But go together. Go together. You need to save those Trebuchets. Go behind the Treb. Okay, he's not doing. He's a bit far. Remember, the Blue March doesn't have the greatest range. He has 8 range and they are elite. Go to the Trebs, Cool. He's not going and he's gonna lose all the Trebs. Ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay. What the hell are you doing, man? He's killing the mill, man. Go with the Wind Raiders. He lost all the damn Trebuchets. Anyway, 130 population fighting the same and raiding a lot. Now they are trying to trade. Well, they have 2 markets. They are doing markets? No, they are not trading. Remember, 20 trade Cardogao, 15 fire. The others is 0. If the game keep going longer and they are not trading, GG call. But 4 markets now for Cool, a lot of Blue Marches, Wood Raiders at the barrel limit, Fire 90 Valise, 20 military, Cool 67, ACCM 44, which is a lot of army combined, over 100, while Dogao and Fire has, right now, absolutely nothing. Nothing. No army at all. Okay, some Axeman, but he's coming with the Blue Marches. Blue Marches are fantastic against that. There you go, coming with more and more Wood Raiders. Craziest stuff, Cool. 200 population. Remember that the mines are so cheap. You can make a lot of farming and you can also slink. Cool doing the halberdiers. ACCM and Fire doing the blast in the last upgrade. And he keep trying. Go, go, go. Oh, if he's getting the trade. Go for the trade. They might not be thinking in the trade because they are not trading themselves, right? But the other team is doing. And now this is looking good for Vietnam. Whoa, what a game. Going back. A lot of now, well, good amount of cavalry. 144 HP. They are strong, but the Wood Raiders with the Blue Marchers, yes. Oh, going to take the trade. If they take the trade, then that's it. Fire 120 population. Like you said, France without the greatest economy, problems, real problems. And the Blue Marches, they are killing now, but he's there with the huge cut. So go with the Wood Raiders, try to go together and kill absolutely everything. Anyway, he keep coming. You can see Dogao, how he can make army super fast. He's the god, 60 military now in seconds. He was with nothing and now 60. Everything sent there. He's gonna lose all the Wood Raiders, definitely. He has the Cavaliers and the huge cuts, but now he's coming back again. And he can push there. That's the problem probably for the Brazilians. He's doing a siege workshop. He has another castle. He needs to go and kill with Wood Raiders, halves, and everything. Hoardings. They are doing all the stuff. They are starting to make the market to make a good trade. And here in the middle, oh man, their raiding is constant. That's the problem. They don't let Fire recover. That's the good thing. I mean, you see also these crazy comebacks in games because some of the players, it's not that they play sloppy. They just maybe are a bit contemplative and not attacking, don't know if they want to boom a bit more or mass more army. It seems that they are pushing, I mean, they are constantly raiding Fire. And that makes that Fire is right now with only 100 population, 74 villages, 14 army, and a lot of Fire builds, but at the very limit. Fire. Well, you can see he has some resources, but his population is really, really low. Now with Siege Ramsey, he's gonna kill all those stables, definitely. Yeah, killing all, man, killing all, and the push is real. Wow. Well, they keep trying, but I really think... Well, that's a good question. That's a good question. With some walls, he needed time. He needed time to get some delay. That's the problem. He got push, and... Yeah, and Dogao could finish Green, definitely, because Green cannot attack Dogao. That's absolutely. But also he needed the walls to himself, to recover himself. He wasn't in the greatest position either, definitely. Well, because he just have the, yeah, the gather point sent to all the side, just to wanted to raid, and he forgot all that. He's just multitasking with the hotkeys, and then he's going for all the stables, one for one, and doing units. He's not paying attention right now to Microdad. Well, he's still in the game with 124 population, trying to recover, which is great. They take the games like it is, super seriously, and try to make their best, but seems to be pretty low. Anyway, they still have also trade, so you never know with the power of the gods. But the Wood Raiders, the champions, yeah, if the Celt is going super crazy aggressive, it's really complicated. He can kill all that army, and he will kill it. I think if he's getting this fight and killing the castle here, they might call the GG. It's possible, man. It's possible because the push is real, man. The push is real, at least in the bottom. On top, no. On top is different. It's really, really different. But here, there you go, man. It's a lot of farming. It's really, really a lot of farming. House Wood Raiders, Cavaliers, Siege Rams. Look at this, man. Almost 200 population, fire 155. Oh wow, he's going down a bit the population, like I'm telling you. Well, the military, no, that there's still a lot of farming. 80 army, the Mayans, 40 ACCM, cool ACCM, yes. But here it's unbelievable, man. It's unbelievable how the Mayans is unable to do damage to the others. Wow, it's just crazy. It's really, really crazy. Well, let's see, guys, let's see what is gonna happen with 150 population. The thing is that the populations still look so close, man, so close, and they are not finishing. Fire still with 81 village. Look at his economy. He's gonna make the paladin upgrade. Oh man, and they have a lot of trade. That really helps, I'm telling you. They don't have trade at all, and with the trade they are also some raiding. I don't know, man, but it's possible that they are coming back. Cool, no resources. Dogao at the limit. ACCM, no gold. They don't trade, man. They do not trade. You don't trade, the game goes so long and you die. You die. Let's see, man. Let's see. They don't give up. They are warriors and the game is getting closer and closer. He should build forward military buildings. He's not doing. And if fire, I am on fire point of view because I think it's the key. If he's able to recover and make some strong stuff with the Franks, they will win it, man. They will win it because I see that. Ooh, this is a lot of farming, but where is the Mayans? Alright, in that spot. You need to be really careful. The Celts now with a lot of farming. It's a lot of farming. Light caps for fire. He's not doing the paladin upgrade. He is at the limit still with the goal, with the resources. He need trade with it or ramps. And already, exactly, look. I was trying to kill, but he's sending one ram only. He should raid, man. I mean, when he's trying, really, when he's trying to get this castle, avoid that shit and go here, man. When he's trying to go there, he don't need to go there. Go here with rams, push all the economy and the trade is here. What's going on, man? A stubborn play by ACCM, really. Better he finish, otherwise, we will see. We will see. Well, he's sending food, a lot of food to fire, and he is doing the paladin upgrade. Paladin upgrade. Now, to go on fire. Are leading the score in this amazing and crazy game. Blue Marchers, Wood Raiders, Halves, and everything. Heal advantage for the Gallant Fire. And the Power of the God is still there pushing, and here he's trying to help. A lot of Blue Marchers, he's gonna kill now those, it's possible. Sending Siege Rams, and here with more and more Blue Marchers and Halves, let's put all them together. But really, they are not finishing the game. They still have no trade at all. And when he's going to make the Paladinos, let's see if he's gonna be able to mass Paladins and Oath. Because if he's going to be able to make like 30 Paladins, I want to see what they are going to do against Paladins, Huge Cats, and Axe Maximus. I really want to see this with only halves and blue marchers. But right now, he's losing all the fucking cavaliers. Unbelievable how you lose all those cavaliers before you get the upgrades. Oh my. Ay, ay, ay. Well, Fire has a stone to make like two castles. Maybe make a castle here to protect your economy, or maybe even closer here. Alright, we will see. But finally, he's going to the left with Wood Raiders. Alright, alright. The good thing for ACCM and Cool is that Mayans and Celt, at least the unit that Celt is doing, because remember that he could go for Siege Ornaments or Scorpions or whatever, they don't need that much gold, right? If he chooses all the units, yes. So, maybe with that trade, they are okay with 20 trade cards. But I think Green will need more anyway. And now, seems that they have more Pluma. Oh, the Paladinos. The Paladins are there, but not an old Paladins. Not an old army for Fire. Not an old. No, he has one Paladin there. But he's there with Wood Raiders. He's there with Wood Raiders. Well, if it's not Blue Marches, it's not that important. Now, if he's coming with more Axeman, it's unbelievable that this game keep going, man. That he didn't kill this game. Now he's trying to get the heal advantage. Finally, put with the Blue March. And if they kill all that trade, ay, a lot of halts and Wood Raiders. If they kill that, oh, this is a lot of farming. Fire cannot stop that. And they are going to kill all the trade. Fire is going down, dramatically down. He's sending huge calls. But this is a lot of army from the Celts. Look at the military, guys. 100 army, cool. 100 killing all the trade. All the trade and 70 army ACCM. This is getting closer to the GG, guys. Now he's switching again. And Vietnam is going to get the game after a huge and solid fight by Brazilians. Look at the military. Almost 200 population in army. The Vietnam, whoa, crazy amount of army, 100 army, really, and 70 military here from ACCM, that's the way to go. They say 24, but when they say 24, means 69, you know what I mean? They are getting so excited because they know that they are getting the game. How good way, there's a lot of blue marches, and he's gonna kill it, man, he's gonna kill it, everything. They are killing a lot of trade. Well, good amount of Paladin is coming with more house and more house. The huge cards now are doing the job, but the population don't go on fire. Look at now the population. Even if they have to go back, they just need to send a guy in house, and that's it. Let's see, guys, let's see. Green is playing amazing. Remember, playing amazing with Mayans. He's against God, and he keep pushing. He never got problem at home. He's stopping Dogao all the game, and he's helping in this spot. It's crazy. Well, they don't resign. They still, man. No, Green played really strong, Jacinth, because he has a civilization that he can't do nothing against the gods, and he is still in no problems here. Well, all is about combos, about combinations, but here, ACCM is the key. ACCM with the Celts can kill everything. Everything. Well, but the problem is that they kill a lot, yes. And now, it's 115 population, they are going to push. They will call the GG in less than 2 minutes. Definitely, man, definitely. With Raiders, Blue Marches and Hells. Go, go, go. Yes, and now Siege Rams, no more army anymore, no more villagers, this is over. This is over with almost no trade, it's amazing job, man. Attacking the trade with cavalry is nothing in comparison with the Blue Marchers, because the Blue Marchers kill one trade card each second. You have to go and chase all the trade. It's not the best choice, it's not the best choice. Anyway, This is now another huge attack and the game probably. He's sending a lot of Paladin. Well, the last army he has, Fire, at the limit, at the very limit, with the food, with the gold, a lot of us, and they are calling the GG, like I say. I'm calling the GG. They are calling the GG. Wow, fantastic first game and crazy. Military. Dogao killed the most, but lost the most, which is normal. Fire was low with the military, 39 only. He was all the time at the limit. Cool did great against gods, killing almost the same that he lose, and ACCM should have positive ratio unit kills and death, but he was negative. I think ACCM could could have done a bit better. But anyway, in total, the game was absolutely fantastic. Fantastic. Crazy strong game, guys. Stay tuned. We're going for another amazing game. This is 1-0 for Vietnam. Oh man, if all the games are going to be like this, I will need some help to keep my energy. Stay tuned.